here we are in the front yard. Look at those steps. And the mountain. And our side view.
Hey.
Hey.
How's it going? This is the stuff they want you to see at the website.
This is what you see at the website. Trees.
Mountains,
cobblestone. Ice, mountains.
Clear. Birds. The reality is what?
You leave your windows closed because...
It's hard to see from here, but...
Over the hill.
Take it over there.
Oh yeah, you can see through the bushes. The freeway. But that's okay, let's go inside. And inside, oh, look at this. A four-post bed. Kind of messy. They left
Kelly
it messy.
Slept last night.
Yeah, Mark slept.
Right here.
On the couch. This is the couch. His bags, of course, laid out. And the armoire. And another window. And another window.
Kelly's CD player with the batteries that ran out.
Another window. Yes. We'll have to stop back at Sal for that.
Upset.
Mark, are you going to show us out that window?
There's nothing out here. There's a bush.
Oh. And on the other side of the bush?
The freeway.
The freeway.
Fortunately, there's not a lot of traffic this time of year, so it was pretty quiet.
We lucked out. Bathroom. Funny shower.
Like a phone booth.
Like a phone booth. Watch. I have socks. Oh, man.
What?
Yes.
Let's show the kitchen.
And look at the little dining room. Mark's reading supplies. Two chairs. Another window. Some flowers. And a beautifully stocked kitchen. Another window. Microwave, you know the whole bit. But this is the king of the kitchen. The coffee machine.
With the coffee that you didn't even want to drink because it tasted like mud.
But we have a Coke. Now we're on our way.
Now I'm going to turn the camera on Kelly real quick. Howdy.
Howdy.
Sunshine, how's it going?
It's going great. What time is it? Let's go.
It's getting about 11 o'clock. We're going to head up and go see the General Sherman tree today, huh? What did we do yesterday?
Mark is really excited.
Yeah, what did we do yesterday?
We saw the Lee tree.
The General Lee and the General Grant.
We saw the Grant, which wasn't quite as beautiful as Mark had anticipated. However, it was huge. It was glorious. It was indescribable and
yeah.
Beautiful.
So
and
hope
snowing.
And why did I not get it recorded yesterday?
Because Mark didn't bring the tape.
Among other things.
You got the camera but
yeah.
No tape.
Well, we've remedied that. Went down and bought a tape yesterday, so we should get some footage of this Sherman tree today, okay?
Okay.
Alright. So
out.
Here we go.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. Bye. This is why we only had two sausages each this morning for breakfast. Boys. See this car tilting? It looks like it may fall over the side. There's a reason for that. There's a human being species inside, we think.
I really wish you'd stop recording. See the nice scenery.
Mark thinks there. Oops, I wasn't recording. Now I am. Okay, now we can see the canyon almost.
Well, the area that we're going to, I guess, is within hiking distance of that big rock.
Ah, it's called Moro Rock?
Uh-huh. Moro. Short for Moron Rock. You're a moron if you hike out on that thing. I think we've been pretty lucky with the weather.
It's beautiful. They knew we were coming.
It's a little gray, but...
I spoke with Mother Earth.
Supposed to be dry, I guess.
What is this?
It's Castle Rocks. Right over there is Moro Rock, that big old thing to your left. It's all down the road.
Oh, we can just hike right over there.
Actually, I think when we get to the top, there's a trail that goes there.
Let's go.
It's pretty, though.
It's beautiful. This is beautiful.
It's amazing.
It's a little overcast, but still sunny. Warm.
Alright. Here we are about 5 minutes up the road from no snow and oak woodlands. Suddenly we're in an area where the giant trees are. And lots of snow. It's amazing. You can tell which ones are the sequoias because of their bark. They're really red.
Grail of trees, the General Sherman. As you can see at the top part, it's kind of broken off, burnt, scarred. This is one amazing tree. We haven't quite got over there yet because we thought this was a good view from a distance. Park ranger over there talking about it. I'm gonna go over there and stir it up with him, so we'll see you in a minute.
This tree.
You want me in for perspective?
Sure.
me if it starts to crack.
Wow, look how small you are next to that tree. Tell me about that tree.
I had to zoom in and out, right? There's a little bar there. Move that. It's got a little green dot at the end of it. There you go.
Now I see how small you are compared to that big guy. It doesn't end.
You want to get over there? Look at that. Tree barely fits into the whole wide range of this camera.
It snows constantly, just a little bit.
Snow drops from it? Yeah. Break my neck. Pretty neat, huh? Yeah? What do you think? Your favorite tree? No, you still like that other one, huh?
Still like Lee.
Okay. This is a little sign next to the tree giving us all the facts. It is estimated age, weight, height. It's a big tree.
Other types of trees are taller or thicker at the base, but no other living thing on this planet exceeds the volume of this giant sequoia.
Yep. Pretty impressive.
Incredible.
As I've been pointing out to some of the rangers around here, it's going to be replaced pretty soon by a coastal redwood tree. And they haven't heard anything about that, so I'm a little more up on things than they are, yeah.
Mark has been
glowing. I should apply for a job here because I know more than they do. All right. Okay, here we are enjoying the tree from all sides. This is the back side of the tree. Kelly, put away that chainsaw.
Don't tell me.
What?
Only in California.
Throw a snowball at it. Watch it crack and fall down with the might of your throw. Not at me! I said the tree! Tree, not me! Come on now.
I couldn't resist.
Watch, throwing at it. Crack! Oh my god, there goes the tree! That would make the world news, I'll tell you.
We don't know how.
What do we have here, Kelly?
Strong and hard these trees
We've
can become.
We've got a couple of kids traipsing around inside the barrier here.
And the dad is just walking by.
And the dad over there, which, to be honest with you, looks like he's from LA.
Mexico.
He's hiding behind the tree. I got you, buddy. I got you, buddy. You're on camera. It's you, irresponsible parent, allowing your kids to traipse around this tree. It's a beautiful thing.
As I began
to say,
as I started to say, it's the roots that are what slows them down in growth because they're weak.
I won't be surprised if this guy walks over here and urinates on the tree. Issy, what's up, Issy?
He's calling the rest of his family.
Oh God, let's get out of here. He's just ruined the whole thing for me. Babe, we're just kind of walking around here. There's some really awesome big trees in this area. This is part of the giant forest near the Sherman tree.
all these big old trees in here. A lot of them have names, they're named after generals and famous people. For some reason, they stopped naming trees. So some of the largest trees out here have no name to them. I'm not sure why. But we're gonna try to walk back in here, look at some more significant trees. Hopefully a little pathway won't be too blocked. Okay. Going along what's called the Congress Trail. Beautiful little creek through here. Some monsters. More monsters. This snowy trail, came across this burned out tree. Thought it was pretty interesting. The whole thing charred. There's another neat little area underneath here. Basically out where nobody's walking. I'm stupid enough to walk out here. But you can enjoy some solitude when you do that. Water is pure, it's pure good. Some random shot here. Just thought it was pretty cool. Those in the background. Big old Methuselah tree here. May have a name, may not. Let's hook up with this little trail here and head on back. See another wild out here. What we've determined is the Lincoln tree. It's another majestic tree. Why don't you stand over near it? Go on over there. Size comparison.
Hmm?
Size comparison.
I know, but we don't want to hurt his root.
There's so much snow around it, we're not stepping on its roots. Amazing. Now there's a comparison. That helps.
Does it?
Yeah. Yeah, now we can really see the enormity of this tree, the Lincoln tree. Out here, this little snow-beaten path, not too many people walking over here this time of year. They all go see the Sherman tree, but it was well worth the hike back in here. Kelly feels a oneness with these trees. Been a good experience for her. The Lincoln tree. Alright, here we are again at the Lincoln tree. Just found out it's the fifth largest sequoia tree in the world. And it's kind of cool that we're here by ourselves. It's not blocked off so we can walk over near it. Respect it. We're not going to trample its roots and stuff, but I just thought this was an interesting perspective this close to the tree.
What's going on, everybody? Huh? What are we all doing tonight?
Burning cookies.
Burning cookies. We got Jim, Paul, Stephen,
Darren here.
What's up, man? What's the matter? You afraid to see your face on camera? Huh?
He's wanted.
I'm wanted.
40 states.
Got a newcomer here tonight. What the heck is that? Look at that.
Ew!
Oh, look at that stupid tattoo he put on his arm.
Ew!
That trendy little tattoo that he can never get rid of. Hey!
Tonight, what are you guys doing here? Huh?
It's your birthday, man.
Your birthday.
All right.
Hey! We don't cuss around here. We don't cuss.
No.
We don't do any cussing around here. We don't do any fingers or anything like that and do magic.
My son might be watching this someday.
Fig nuts.
I'm gonna have to pass this on to my son. You know, this is my legacy.
You.
These are all my friends. It's something for him to look up to. Yeah, my dad's turned 31 this day, and he's hanging out with all these dudes. Hanging out with a bunch of guys and want to sit here and play video games all night.
Darren's cussing over there. Cody, don't do that.
Hey!
Gaylord Empire. Pepsi, the choice of our generation.
Hey, who's getting themselves work tonight, huh?
Your ass.
Nah, you guys are getting work.
Flag.
Here's the best team right here.
Yeah!
Team Blue. Yeah! Team Blue.
Kicking their butts all the way.
That's Team Red over there.
It's all the TV. It's just the TV.
You guys stink.
You ready to prove that, right, Mark?
Yeah, we proved it. It's not the TV.
TV's like three
it's all about the skill.
Now. You gotta tape this game, Mark.
It's all about the skill.
Prove it. Tape this game to prove
no,
it.
No, don't, Mark.
Nah, we're not gonna record this game.
Yeah,
we all know. What are you talking about, dude?
Hell fucking.
Hell fucking Jason.
Hey, I'm getting this on tape. I'm turning it into your dad, man.
My dad won't care.
Oh, that's right. You cuss to him.
My dad'll crack up.
Everybody clams up.
And then he'll fire me.
I get this thing on. Everybody shuts up.
My dad'll laugh his ass off. Then he'll fire me.
You gonna fart or something, dude? Such good stuff. Such good footage here.
You can give this to your children?
Yeah. My descendants are going to see this stuff.
Yeah, all one of them. Yeah, they also want to see the piece of crap I took in there.
Drop it!
Look at who.
Oh my god, Darren's giving Lee head. He's begging.
I am definitely going to have to erase all this.
Lee, keep it aside.
This stuff cannot be seen by the public. It's all wacky. Somebody's got...
Nuts!
Hey, Mark!
Somebody's got...
First!
Mark!
Hey, sit back. Somebody's got earwax in their ear and a booger in their nose. Kick him. Kick him with the camera. Where is he? Trying to hide, huh? Look at this guy. What a hermit.
Smoking dope there?
Did he run out? I'm going to get him.
Break.
Why did Darren not like the camera?
No pictures. Darren, why didn't like the camera? Okay, I'll do that, but you won't do the porno that you wanted.
There he is. There's the subhuman. There's the hermit. There's the troglodyte.
Did you say hermaphrodite?
Then why did you hit the camera? Are you Native American? Think you're gonna steal your soul?
Yes.
Your soul, you don't have your soul. It's already gone.
Well, I don't have a soul anymore. That's right.
Ew. Ew.
On his pants.
Let's see that nice smile.
This guy is nuts.
Lee, is there something you wanted to add?
Yeah.
Don't.
What? You got something else to say?
Yeah, I have something to say.
What? Say it.
Okay.
Lee, what's the most annoying sound in the world?
That's
Let's treat him.
Treat him.
Who's the first one to crap out tonight?
Hey guys, come on. Starting.
Hold on.
Dude.
You're blocking the whole camera shot, jackass.
Oh.
And it's starting.
Oh. Oh. Well, that's me, isn't it?
Okay, there we go.
See the drool coming out?
Joe Mark.
Who?
Yeah.
Who?
Yeah.
We haven't played long enough.
Yum. Dude, I heard vanilla ice and then chocolate ice.
What's this?
Oh, I got a gift.
Yeah, especially worth it.
Read it. Wait. Turn it over.
Oh. Happy birthday, jackass. I mean, Mark.
Hell yeah!
He knows what I want.
Sweet!
I had that before you even said that.
Jay and Silent Bob strike back. Hey, man.
I had that already before you even said it.
This is great. Cool.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Who'd you give me?
You brought his presents.
Oh, you got your
drink. I'm like, having a shy job.
You brought his presents over. They all made their presents known.
My admission is here today.
Yeah, they all made their presents known.
Yeah, everybody's flipping me off. Thank you.
You guys are Berg.
Oh, wait. Mark. I'm sorry. I forgot. I feel left
you're
out.
Number
I'm not going back over there.
Just think of them as candles, Mark. Expect a few more.
Me.
Doing? You gonna scoot? And there he goes. Cody, where are you going?
Here,
come here.
Me?
Yeah, ride your bike for a minute.
I just took it up.
Well. There you go. I have green. Thank you. No pinching. Gone forever.
Happy birthday, Mark. How does it feel to be 31?
I don't know. You tell me. You've been there for about
great.
10 months.
That's right. No, not 10 months.
Okay.
8 months.
8-ish.
It feels good. I feel good.
Do you?
I feel great.
You know it's March 17th. Do you have any green on?
Yeah, but I can't show you. Not
don't
on camera.
Give me that. You lie.
No, I'm not.
I'm gonna pinch you. Pinch.
I carry Nicholas around. He has green on.
Ha! Nope, doesn't work. Here comes Cody. Cody, do a jump. Do a jump for me. Entertain me. That's great. Jump off that speed bump. Come here. Be a clown.
What?
Be a clown. Jump off the speed bump over here. Quick, jump. Oh, that's great. Turned out to be a nice day, huh? What are we doing today?
We're celebrating your birthday today.
A day after my actual birthday, yes. Huh?
Well, we did that last night as well.
Okay.
We make a week event of it.
I like that. So when does yours start? July 20th?
Picture.
Yeah. What are we doing here, guys? Trying to get our skates on? Turned out to be a monumental project, huh, Cody? Just trying to get the tongue straight on there.
Wow, Nicholas, you didn't need my help after all.
Isn't that amazing? You guys can do this on your own.
Of course, I'm sure you'd prefer the no narration.
Yeah.
What's that? You got something to say? Say it.
Say it. Because
you're
right
on tape.
Here.
I like the no narration part.
Why? Oh, no. Talk to me. Look at me.
Hi.
What you got to say there?
Happy birthday, Dad.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Good.
I'm glad you have the holiday spirit, Cody.
These guys are about ready to skate. All right. There he goes. Yeah. And what do we got here?
You don't need to use that.
Skater number two, Nicholas. I thought you were better than that. There you go. All right. Man, no problem.
Let's see how the speed bump works.
Jump the speed bump.
Jump the bump. First day?
Yeah.
Is there like, can I change aperture or anything like that? I guess I can't.
Oh, no.
I'm not trying to change anything. We're not directing a movie here.
Direct the movie.
Yes, we are.
I'm blowing out two candles.
Before you blow out the
can
candles?
Can you handle that?
Not yet.
Action!
You know, if you put 31 on there, I think that pudding would have been all over the table.
Yeah, that's what I thought too.
That pudding frosting?
Where's your friend? Did he go home?
Yeah.
The pudding cake.
Been waiting longer.
He has to go home. No more cake for him.
Ready?
Okay, let's turn.
Oh. Oh wait, guys, the camera. Okay.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Cha cha cha.
Happy birthday, dear Mark. Happy birthday to you.
Cha cha cha. And many more on Channel 4. A big fat lady on Channel 80.
Hey. Never heard of that one.
Hey.
That's a new one.
That is a new one.
Extension.
Got that recorded.
Hey, Scooby-Doo!
Cody, you're getting beat up. It's good.
Oh, no.
Grandpa, get him. Get him.
Grandpa's dead.
Kick him.
Oh,
watch out. You dislocated it.
What?
Huge.
What?
You're huge.
Hey, Mark, we're back on you now.
Can I have it? Can I have it?
You can turn that off any time you want.
What?
That.
Why? Don't like it, do you?
It's
kind of crazy when it shoes under the foot.
What?
When I was snoring. No, no.
No. Not only were you snoring, you picked your nose.
I did?
You picked your nose.
I saw that. I saw
that was last time
I did?
You saw that. Yeah, that's right.
I didn't mean to pick my nose.
Yeah.
Oh.
Sure did. I'll show you later.
No, thank you.
I thought it was Ice Cube. I thought it was part of a film. Nope.
I want to see that.
No, Cody, you're not going to see it.
Oh, man.
How about I film you when you're sleeping, Mark?
Wait, you didn't pull the old...
Did he film you when you were sleeping?
You didn't pull the old shaving cream?
Yeah, he filmed me when I was sleeping.
Trick
on
it,
nice guy.
You were going to do the shaving cream trick?
Yep.
Yeah.
You know that thing where they put something on your nose
put
and they put shaving
in the water,
cream in your hand and you go like this?
You ever see that?
You ever see that happen?
No.
Too late now.
They keep tickling your nose, you know, and you keep going like this, and then pretty soon they put shaving cream on your hand, and you go.
Oh, gosh.
Are you putting their fingers in water?
Yeah.
Kind of induces them to pee on themselves, basically.
They tried that before. It doesn't work with me.
I'm hungry.
You want some of that?
Cody, you're last.
To you, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Lee.
Hey.
3-1.
Happy birthday to you. Hey, what's going on?
Got to drive through the tree.
Went to the drive-through tree?
Went to the drive-through tree.
Yeah?
We're officially tourists.
Was that, like, exciting?
It was incredibly exciting.
It's a thrill?
This is exciting. That was it. This is exciting.
This is nice out here, huh?
Nice.
It's real pretty. A little pond back here. Little meadow, birds.
Flowers, trees, grass. Not very many people.
People are behind us, huh?
Yeah.
At the gift shop. And the drive-through tree.
Buying many drive-through trees.
Yeah? Hey, do you want to go in the gift shop?
I'm a little tempted.
Are you? That doesn't surprise me. All right, so maybe we'll venture on over there.
Okay. That was Mark. He's going to drive through the chandelier tree. Up, up, up. Gently or impatiently for these people that are taking a picture. Here he comes. Wave, Mark.
The old Dyerville giant. Pretty cool stuff. Perched up here on this big log. I don't know, this could be the Dyerville giant. All we know is it's fallen over. This is the Dyerville giant for sure. It fell over about 10 years ago. And was the largest coast redwood. This whole area's got a lot of fallen giants, but without a doubt, this is the biggest one. I guess one of these other lesser giants fell over and knocked into it, weakened it, causing it to fall over in a storm. Again, at the Dyerville giant, we can see what happened here. Right through this area, just cleaning off the whole side of this one redwood, taking all of its branches off with it.
Wow, it's 2 feet taller than Niagara Falls.
Kelly says it was 2 feet taller than Niagara Falls. on around 370 feet tall, was the biggest. Fortunately, never saw it standing. Stand over next to this thing. Look at you. And look at this thing. You can see it's weakened by this one falling years before, and then it eventually fell on top of this one. It goes on and on and on down there. 370 feet. More random shots. Let's see how far up it goes. Most of these trees are well over 300 feet tall. It's just still amazing no matter how many times I've been here. Still get a good thrill out of it. It's a foggy day today. That's what these trees like. Hey, here we are. Heading towards the giant tree. There it is, from a distance. Absolutely the biggest tree around here. As you can see.
How tall is it?
Dominates the area. Oh, it's over 350 feet. So, we're gonna head over there and get a closer look. As you can see, this is the giant tree. Pretty impressive. And there's the tree itself.
Look, I'm almost 6 feet tall.
Yep. Kelly's standing next to it for perspective. You seem a little bigger though.
What?
Than that other, the other Sequoia giant that you were standing next to.
Yeah.
These aren't quite as big around. Oh, they are vastly taller.
Yeah.
Way taller than the Sequoia giants. Neat though. Here, you wanna film me?
Sure. Look how big you are. Well, maybe not. Down here, you're going to be close up. Give the tree a hug. You like that tree?
I love this tree. Never ceases to amaze me every time I come here.
Go on.
Well, you know how big it is.
Is this your favorite tree out here?
Yeah. Why wouldn't it be? This is the biggest of them all.
You like them big, huh? This is pretty.
Yeah. It's beautiful out here. I like the whole area.
Me too.
A lot of giants out here.
They're everywhere.
Not all of them have names.
Far more than Sequoia. A lot of birds.
I can't hear those ravens squawking.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of cool.
We got a high school here. Let's see what their education system looks like.
In God we trust. It's God this and God that.
They don't have real roads with little shaky, so pardon me.
This dirt road to get out of this high school. Shit, you need a 4x4 to get out of here.
Well, I'm sure they all have them.
Check that out. Wow.
Wow.
This is your high school, people.
Guess they didn't get any tax money.
Huh. The Matoli Triple Junction High School. Good Lord.
Have a nice view.
It's pretty out here. There's the administration building over there. The basketball courts.
The one-lane bridge?
It's not the Golden Gate. It's the Green Gate.
It's the one, yeah. You can only go 10 miles an hour out here.
Pretty cool.
It's a little unstable.
Little hidden treasures out here. On the Matoli River. Ready?
Mm-hmm. No hands.
Is it crazy or what? Wow.
You made it.
We're gonna make it. If not, hopefully somebody will get this videotape. Find out our last location. Approaching the coast.
Thank you.
it out to the ocean. Amazing. Look at all that sandy beaches. Nobody. Nobody out on these beaches. Gorgeous. Come around the corner and here we are. Wow. Humboldt Coast. We are out here now. Find a place to pull over, run out there to the beach. Everything seems to be fenced off out here. Made it out here. Found a spot to pull over. Come down here. What's going on? At another beach?
Things
a trip over? What are you talking about?
I fell.
Wow.
Mark trips
me. Yeah, sure I did. Down there?
Yeah.
Yep. Big boo-boo. Gonna get over it?
Yeah. I'm over it.
Alright, let's take a look at this beach here. We're over by the Redwood National Park Visitor Center, which is right over there. And plenty of driftwood out here. It's the main feature. A few people walking around out here. Obviously a very foggy day. But still pretty. Nice beach. Hey, little guy. What's going on? Where'd you go? Oh yeah, he likes big newts. Yeah, he's heading off. Yeah. I got a little bit of him. Here
big Douglas fir. This is a mixed forest. Unlike the one we were in yesterday, which was all pure redwoods. This has a mixture of big redwoods, big Douglas fir, and other plants and trees. We're up on a ridge, different kind of environment, not a lowland area, but the trees are all impressive nonetheless. Ladybird Johnson Grove, Redwood National Park. Very nice. A lot of flies. One thing we've noticed around here.
Kelly hasn't fallen yet.
And mosquitoes, no, Kelly has not fallen yet. But we've got plenty of opportunity for her to do that. I just like turning on the recorder. There's so many pretty things to see that I'll want to relive at home when I can't make it up here. Okay, there we have a plaque. Lady Bird Johnson Grove.
Want to read it?
Nah, it's cool.
She's...
July 30th, 1969. Almost 32 years to the day that Richard Nixon was up here. 33, excuse me, you're right.
She said if we all went through places like this, we would be much happier. She's right.
Yep. Grow. Through here. Very sunny. Little bench down there to sit at. Be stopping and reading every signpost on the little brochure, the nature walk. Hi. You like it out here?
I love it out here.
It's great, isn't it? If we only had some fly repellent, it'd be perfect.
They're not bugging me too bad.
You're too bad?
They're too busy eating you alive.
Well, that's because I wore shorts. Made a mistake of wearing shorts today. Oh well.
Now it's my turn. I'm going to do a little turnabout because where I stand has probably hundreds of different life forms. And when I look at the video, I can remember where I was. Probably hear the flies, they're starting to bug me too. But it's worth it. Let's see what Mark's up to. What are you doing?
Getting alive, let's go.
I'm back in control of the camera now. Looking for little berries. Nice. You find the little berries down there? There were some right behind you somewhere. Little red berries. I saw a few.
Those are salmon berries.
Yeah. Put those on your hook and fish for salmon. No?
No.
Okay.
Make you a cobbler out of them.
Yeah, they're poisonous. I bet you would, wouldn't you? Here, eat this.
Come on, I'm getting eaten alive. Let's go!
No, you're not, because you were smart enough to wear pants. You got a long sleeve shirt. And I'm in trouble out here. I got all kinds of bite marks on my leg.
And the tick book said don't wear dark clothes.
Am I wearing dark clothes?
Your shirt is.
Don't trip. Watch where you're walking. Don't brush against these ferns. There's all kinds of ticks in them. Waiting to jump out. Get all swolled up with your blood. Yeah. Just walk over near this tree for perspective. Okay. Yeah, you look small. Not as small as that tree up Sequoia, though.
No.
You know?
Did you get this rainbow tree?
Yeah, rainbow, dead rainbow tree. This tree, though, probably much taller than that one, Sequoia Park.
Mark.
What's going on?
We made it. I made it. I had to carry him across. What is that bug on that rock? Probably a big tick.
Nah. There's a lot of dragonfly nymphs and stuff out here.
But we made it to the creek. Not quite as close as we thought it was, but
yeah.
It was worth it.
What a hike out in here. This is Redwood Creek, part of Redwood National Park. A lot of old growth timber around here. This is the way we like it. Okay, what we have here, just make it out. Yeah, they do. Some elk, Roosevelt elk. Can't really walk out there, but this is as close as we're going to get, I guess. On foot, danger. Okay, that one just got up, so we're gonna keep recording. So Kelly, we are winding up our second day.
Is it already the end of the second day?
No, we still got a nice seafood dinner waiting for us tonight. Is that what you want? Okay. We're about 30, 35 miles north of Eureka. And we just got back from going down Redwood Creek. It was a long hike down there, wasn't it?
It was a really long hike. Sandals.
Inappropriate shoes, huh? Where are they at? Yeah.
But I didn't fall.
No, you didn't fall this time. That's a good thing.
Show them the ocean.
So, here we are. Drove out. Saw some elk. Drove down this road. Came out here to this beach. beautiful. It's nice, it's warm. 65 to 70, I'd say. Big old beach, very few people out here. Kelly's gonna run down and check out the water for me. I see some people in already. They think it's pretty nice. Well, have a go. All right, there she goes. Good luck. Think? This isn't Hawaii.
No, it's not.
This is Northern California.
It's not too cool. Let me try.
Want me to try? All right, here we go. Close here. Gotta keep one eye on the ocean and one eye through the viewfinder. Just as they were drying out, got them wet again. Had to fool with Mother Nature.
Yeah. Look what we have here.
Well, that's kind of the thing. What do you do in Michigan, which you live down here? The thing is, what do you do when you go up north? You try to avoid deer.
They're all bulls. Beautiful. Yeah, there is. A lot closer too. Picture?
Pretty good, not as good as when they were standing right here.
Yeah. I got a lot of video footage of them. That guy is huge.
Wow.
Look at those antlers. Isn't that neat? He's fully mature.
Michael, be careful. Don't go too far.
Pisses these hunters off. No way they can't shoot these things. Real close. Right in there.
Were you able to get close enough?
Yep.
See it?
You got a pack of them.
A lot of tourists over here checking this out.
Is that a restaurant right there?
Yeah. You know what? They serve elk meat.
Burgers.
Elk burgers.
How rude.
Probably shoot one of these right out the back porch. Drag them in. We gotta call the horde.
Hurry up, we're running low on meat.
Alright, go shoot one. These might all be domesticated for all we know. I only see the bulls. Because they have more meat on the hood.
Oh, look at those. Antlers.
Amazing, huh?
Huge.
Where all the cows are. In case you thought we were lying, elk steaks, yeah. They kill them right over there in that field.
We took pictures of the little thing.
No, I don't want to take a picture. You might break my camera.
Oh, no.
I took enough pictures.
Oh, no. Oh, your head's nice and warm, too. So is yours.
You smell that. You're lucky. Surrounded by the little boy.
All this warmth.
Nice to meet
Oh, do I have to go through another birthday?
Oh,
really?
Oh,
wow.
Really?
Are there any more Rupert's?
23.
Any of your Rupert's?
Duplicate.
23.
You want me to see it for you?
What? You don't have a camera?
I don't know.
Here, you take the pictures then.
I can.
Come here and sit down.
Mark it down when they film you. Left.
Come on, sit down.
I do
smell. We need a bit. We need matches.
We're here anyway. We've got a lot of
work. There they are.
2 hours.
It's the season. Well,
hopefully not quite 2 hours. I don't, are we going to go home? We're going to go to Auntie's.
Yes. Good decision.
Thank you.
Not
welcome.
Quite as far.
Ready?
Are we ready? I'm hungry.
You're what?
I'm hungry.
You're hungry? Well, it's because you need your hamburger.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't want to hear it.
Long fingers.
He's gonna get half a burger instead of cake.
What are you gonna do with those long fingers?
Really?
What kind of cake is it?
Clarinet,
no.
Oh, cool.
That's cool. Alright, are we ready?
I'm not ready yet. Okay. Whenever you're ready.
Is something
ready?
Yep.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Cha cha cha.
Happy birthday, dear Kelly. Happy birthday to you.
And you look like one, two. Yay! Yay! Right.
You started getting into the food mug. That doesn't take much.
Yeah. Thank you, everybody.
You only hear.
Oh, you wasted a whole match on that?
After that match story, we need some kerosene or something like that.
Okay, everybody
nice.
Smile. Thanks, Nick.
You said smile,
not drink. No goofiness.
Too late now.
Did you hear Mueller hit? Did something burn?
Did you need a knife for that?
Yes.
Nice.
Is that how it shows the, is that the thing that?
No, that's a filling program. That's for in-flight filling.
How did?
Throttle's right there. The top speed of this plane was 644. The sign down there shows 653. That's for enable. Now, this was a carrier base, so when they were on the carrier, the pilot would shift forward to full throttle. Just like that. And this is the hand grip here. You have to hold on to this hand grip. And that way, when they are coming back in their ejection seat, they launch, they do it, they go off the ground, take down the minimum power, and go off the engine.
For which way they put it on the main rear tail that gives it visibility as well as rudder curve.
Here we are at the Sonoma County Air Show.
And so we're always mindful of that, and that's the art form of flying, especially the really large
planes. I knew we should have came here.
These seekers are monsters. They're nice, widely spaced.
Yeah, very good, Nick.
So it's a little different scenario there, but it's one monster of an airplane.
That is, and you mentioned about the wide gear. That's a big factor. The P-51, although it has a bad reputation by some people, is actually supposed to be a very, very nice flying airplane. Dan Martin told me this morning that with that wide gear, he said they have a few characteristics that if you're ready for them, they're actually a very pleasurable airplane to fly. Now, the P-40 Warhawk, when you get down that's the sharp team in front, you'll notice it's got very narrow landing gear. It's a crosswind. They're a real handful.
This was used as a backup. Bombardier Navigator was ever taken out. Now, there's some pilot can still target in.
I think they're going to be
Just like that. Landing gear, pretty simple. It even looks like a landing gear. You got the wheel there, you got the shock, parking brake. Just like in a car. Right there you have your throttle.
You're standing in the skydiver. You're going to also participate in the morning voices. And they're going to be coming up.
This is the plane the kids were just in. The intruder. Hey, saggy britches. How come you didn't put a belt on? I got that on tape. Here he comes.
Drop a bomb!
What if he does?